Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel Galaxy Art Media. In this video I'll show you how to focus a DSLR camera with the Skywatcher Heritage 100mm telescope. The main subject of this video will be how to use a DSLR camera with this telescope to be able to obtain focus. I placed a Nikon D6200 here into the focuser and the problem was I was not able to focus on infinity and to focus on far away objects, only on close objects like 4, 5, 6 meters. The problem that we have when focusing a DSLR with the Newtonian telescope is the distance between the camera sensor and the secondary mirror. The distance is actually too long. This is different compared with refractors. We usually need a longer distance to be able to focus. In this situation, we need a shorter distance to be able to focus with a DSLR. So to be able to fix this problem, we need a Barlow lens that will change the focal point and it will change the required distance to be able to focus with a DSLR camera. So to be able to focus with a DSLR camera, you need a Barlow lens. And I do recommend you a Barlow like this one. This is a variable Barlow, 2.25 and 1.3. This means that you'll be able to remove the Barlow lens. Okay. You'll need to remove here the camera like this. Now you'll be able to place the Barlow. Then we will tighten the camera. And this way we will be able to focus. Using the Barlow like this should be around 1.3. That will increase the focal length about 520, maybe a little bit more at 600. I have to check on the moon to be sure and I'll make some tests soon. So why I do recommend you this one, because we can use only the Barlow lens and we can focus with a DSLR camera without having to magnify so much the focal length. Let me show you the videos that I made with this Barlow. Some simple tests on the town. Okay, so I'll use this Barlow lens to be able to obtain focus with a DSLR camera. I'll remove here the eyepiece and I place the Barlow. I will loosen this knob, this screw, and I'll take the cap. Now I'll place the camera here. I have a T2 ring with a 1/4 inch to T2 nose piece adapter. I'll place it in like this. So we managed to focus using the DSLR camera and I'm also recording, so I'll be able to see what I'm filming. So if I want to get a correct position, I will loosen up here the DSLR and I will turn it until we get the correct angle. Okay, so I managed to focus using the Barlow lens. So I have here my DSLR camera and I do want to test on the moon to see how much it will with a DSLR, because it's different compared with an astrophotography camera because of the distance from the Barlow lens to the camera sensor. So here with this body, I think I had around 4 times Barlow with a DSLR instead of 2.25. And now I do want to see how much I will have if I place the Barlow like this. And now I will take some images. Here I place the Dobsonian mount on a tripod so I can use it more comfortable. On a table is also fine. So here we have the camera. This is the field of view that we have using this Barlow lens. Directly place it on the nose piece of the DSLR camera and we will see how much this Barlow will magnify. Using the Skywatcher Heritage 100mm Newtonian telescope, we have less clouds now. The full moon here with the Skywatcher Heritage 100, 400mm focal length and 2.25 Barlow. Here we have the image that I took with my DSLR using the Barlow lens mounted on the nose piece.
And we can see the field of view is very similar with the one in Stellarium at 3x Barlow. Here we have 4x Barlow magnification in Stellarium. And let's see now the image that I took with the Barlow in standard configuration. It looks like this. So close to 4x Barlow, I would say around 1500 millimeters, maximum 1600. This is how you can check the field of view using Stellarium and having the moon as a point of reference. If you want to obtain a shorter focal length, you can try other Barlow that will magnify less. I do suggest to buy one that you can remove the Barlow lens from the body and place it on other accessories, so you can play with the distance from the Barlow lens to the camera sensor.
I filmed the moon using the Skywatcher Heritage 100mm, a beginner telescope. However, I was impressed. Using a DSLR, you need a Barlow, and also you should expect to have vibrations that might blur the moon if you want to take an image like this. So you should increase also the shutter speed, like I went 640 and then ISO 400. I went even more, up to 1000 shutter speed and ISO 800. Now I will take my Star Adventurer and try to see how it will improve the image quality if I will track.
Now I'm filming the moon at about 68 luminosity using a small Newtonian telescope, the Heritage 100mm, and a 2.25 Barlow lens connected to my DSLR. And to be able to keep the moon in the field of view and to track, I'm using a star tracker, the Star Adventurer 2i. It works very good with this small telescope. What about the field of view that we will have using a DSLR camera on astrophotography with the Heritage 100 and the Barlow lens? We can simulate in Stellarium how we'll be able to capture the Orion Nebula using this setup. And we have it here. I'll show you also how I did focus using a Bakhtinov mask, and I captured the Orion Nebula using this setup. The stars will look like this with a spike in the center. This is an image stack of the Orion Nebula that I captured using the Heritage 100 and the Nikon D7200 camera. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, subscribe, click on the bell notification, and I'll see you soon in more astrophotography videos. Stay safe, and until next time, I wish you clear sky.